those voices? Where am I? I know this place. I've been here before. I've been here my entire life. I'm trapped in here. These stairs. I'm climbing these stairs again. I need to get out. The voices are calling me. Music box. It's broken. I have to fix my old music box. I have to get it. I have to... Those horrible dreams again. I've had them repeatedly ever since my mother died and left me that music box in her will. Harry always said that old family heirloom had something to do with my family's strange disease. If the doctors won't give us an answer about your illness, I'll search for one myself, you said. And in that search, it seems you lost yourself. I don't think I'd ever...
Pardon me, madam, but the island is in sight. We'll be lowering the boat in just a minute.
Oh, thank you so much, Captain Hodgson. I'll be right out. All right. Time to gather my things. I think I've overpacked. What was I thinking when I brought all these dresses on this trip? Oh my, I have the worst memory. I forgot the combination again. Thank goodness I always bring my journal with me to write things down. Oh, I love this song. Oh, I'd better cover up my hands before I leave the cabin. I wouldn't want anyone thinking I'm a circus freak. The amazing adventures of Nora Everhart, art teacher. right. Now it's open. Harry Everhart. My husband, my partner, and my dear old pal. A brass key with the letters CW engraved on it. And some enigmatic instructions. This strange and sharp relic came in the package I received at home. I saw this island in one of my unsettling dreams. I drew it as soon as I woke up. It's a relief that I don't need it to walk anymore.
We're all set, madam. The motorboat is ready.
It's not exactly a clawfoot tub, but you can't always get what you want. After spending so much time reading this book, I think I've learned a thing or two about Polynesian culture. Merveilles de mer du Sud. Marvels of the Southern Seas, I think. I'm definitely going to miss this bed. Falling asleep to the ship's rocking was delightful. I miss the sea so much when we moved to Denver. I'd always dreamed of traveling. It was not the same without you, Harry. I think I've overpacked. Captain Hodgson has a very particular taste when it comes to decor. Okay, Nora. From here on out, you're on your own.
Lower the motorboat. Be careful with Mrs. Everhart's equipment, lads. We'll be back to pick you up in 3 days. I really hope you find your husband there, madam.
I hope it too. I'll see you in 3 days, then.
But please be careful on that island. You know what the legends say about it.
I'll take care. Thank you, Captain Hodgson. Well, here I am, in the middle of the ocean after traveling across half the world. Just miles away from where my husband is supposed to be. You left a year ago to search for a cure for my affliction. Your letters kept me close to you, but suddenly they stopped coming. What happened, Opal? What did you find? Whatever it was, it led you to hire a crew and set sail from San Francisco to Tahiti. And from there, to this place. An island in the middle of the Pacific that the locals refuse to even name. Everything is familiar. So familiar. As impossible as that may sound, is this the island I dreamed about? This can't be a coincidence. Idyllic island, surrounded by deadly reefs and protected with stakes to keep anybody from entering. Why? There's definitely something strange about this place. Let's see if I can find any trace of you around here. A tent. So somebody was on this island recently. That's a vivo, a flute that the Polynesians play with their nose. I won't be playing that. A miniature va'a, a Polynesian outrigger canoe. Beautifully crafted, too. A note written in French. I only understand two words, île and mort, island and death. It must be a warning about the dangers of the island. This machete is completely worn down. The blade is dull. Someone has been chopping down palm trees, a lot of them. Maybe to build something. I feel quite good. I dare say I might even walk a little faster than usual. Those markings seem to represent the sea. I'll make a note of them in my journal. It might come in handy. Looks like it opens from the other side. These wooden figures are called Unu. This seems to be telling a story. It may look peaceful, but clearly somebody wants to keep outsiders off this island. What a lovely flower offering. Carving tool. This box. CW. Those are the initials on the brass key. It opens it. So whoever sent me this key was here. This is starting to look like a scavenger hunt. From what I've read, the Polynesians don't need doors. So why build such a big one? Something's missing here. Something. Well, look what's hidden here. This may be the first time I trespass a private property. My childhood in Newburyport wasn't exactly the most thrilling thing.
Is that... Harry? Harry, you were here!
You were here and I found you, dammit. Where are you now? Where is everybody? Where did you and all your crew go? Lady Shannon? That name sounds familiar. I'd better check my journal. A mechanical bridge? That doesn't fit in with Polynesian traditions either. It's been years since I took such a long walk. This fresh air is doing me wonders. What a beautiful mountainous landscape. Bonefish hook. This sort of pond is a Polynesian fishing technique. There's another symbol inside it. My, this is so beautiful. What were these birds called? Lorikeets. Cole's lorikeets. There are lorikeet feathers scattered around this umu. I'll draw the symbol in my journal. Polynesian chieftains make their head ornaments with lorikeet feathers. What a lovely souvenir. This looks like cargo from an earlier voyage, long before Harry's expedition. A shortcut. That's convenient. and I thought Colorado was too far from home when we moved there. Now that I've crossed half the world, I wouldn't mind crossing the other half. But I have to do it with you,
old pal. Rays of sunlight
shining through. Another symbol. I can feel the air is denser here in this mangrove swamp. This reminds me of those slot machines that Harry and I saw at the Atlantic City Pier, but a Polynesian version. How long have I been walking? I've lost track of the time. Wow, what is this place? I'd better have a look around this abandoned village. Harry's crew might have stayed here. Something missing here. This enormous stone slab looks like a mechanism to get up to the outcrop. Everhard Expedition. They set up camp here.
Let me record it. You said you've been on this island before.
Yes. Some years ago. I made a rookie mistake. I did it from my fishing route to go to what looked like a better spot. Less than an hour had gone. By when suddenly, my canoe overturned. And I got this lovely souvenir from that mistake.
Heavens, what gave you that scar?
It's not a what, but a who. I don't know. I didn't get a good look at it. But it seemed like a sea creature I never seen. Anyway, I was lucky enough to reach that Whiteson beach. The one where we landed on the island. A man came 3 days later and got me out of there. He brought me to the port of Papeete without speaking a single word. Time passed, and I promised myself that I will go on with my life and forget about this damn island.
Why did you agree to return to the island, then?
I need to know what happened to me, to discover the truth. I don't know if you get me.
Absolutely.
Fascinating. Looks like some of the crew members didn't get along too well.
A forbidden ritual?
So now you believe in magic, old pal?
A Polynesian man covered in tattoos. I'm not sure if he looks angry or scared. Well. Broken, but I might as well draw what I can see of it in my journal. It's some sort of Polynesian coat of arms. Is that an octopus? Something's missing inside that emblem. I've never cared much for games of chance. This fella sounds pretty hot-headed. Blowing an ancient hatch with dynamite sounds like a fool's errand to me. Ooh, looks like someone didn't like you very much, Harry. I'm not sure what to expect on this island, but I hope I won't regret not having a gun. Nice comb. Worries this much about their appearance in a place like this. They were packing a lot of heat when they came to this island, but they took all the guns with them. Very neat. Quite a looker. A fashion model, maybe. Looks like this fellow was a real heartbreaker. His real name was Costas? Damn it. Someone on the expedition died. A farewell message from a friend. I never thought that this expedition would cause anybody's death. Oh, I'm sure Harry never thought so either. If he'd known this was going to happen, he'd never have come here. Did they use all the dynamite? He seems confused, as if he was having a hard time writing this down. I hadn't been close to a grave since my mother's burial. Shortly after she died, my lovely Dalmatian spots, as Harry used to call them, appeared. I thought it was nothing at first. The river cuts through that canyon. It doesn't look safe to cross. An amulet with a carved Marquesian cross. The symbol represents balance and protection. Look at this little fellow. Why is this hammock so far from the rest of the campsite? I must have found the luxury huts. Pretty swanky. Look at him. Giddy as a schoolboy. Ikor? Interesting. Well, considering how poorly Harry draws, this isn't half bad. That Frank seems to feel guilty for whatever happened. I feel really bad for him. It's been ripped out of something else. I've seen Harry keep even restaurant checks for bookkeeping. He would never tear up a piece of valuable information. Something's missing inside that emblem. You put together quite an expedition, Harry. And all just for little old me.
My dear old pal. I know you won't ever read this letter, but I'm accustomed to writing you, and it comforts me in this strange place. This island is riddled with secrets. So many secrets. But I'm not only talking about mechanisms and contraptions, Laura. I dare say that something on the island clouds one's judgment. Otherwise, I don't have an explanation for Roy's actions. The man was arrogant, impulsive, and a little cocky, but he was no fool. We weren't friends by any means, but he didn't deserve what happened to him. Nobody deserves that. We may have made some progress in finding the cure for your illness, but at what price? I miss you so much, Nora. Harry.
He may not say it explicitly, but Harry blames himself for Roy's death. I know him too well. And I miss you too, Harry. Where did you get this strange device, Harry? Not really sure how this thingamajig works, or what to do with it. The Harry Everhard I know would never have given up on this. Something must have happened that kept him from solving it. Black ooze? In a telescope?
other planes of existence. That's bats. Jeepers, a stranded ship. This explains why the campsite is nearly abandoned. I'm not really sure how this thingamajig works. Or what to do with it. I'm not really sure how this thingamajig works, or what to do with it. I'm not really sure how this thingamajig works, or what to do with it. parts of the tiki on this column seem movable. Stranded ship. Something's missing here. I'm not really sure how this thingamajig works, or what to do with it. Got it. Tiki, like something straight out of an adventure novel. Could these tikis be some sort of guardians?
Something's missing inside that emblem. They're composed of four pieces. What a delicate piece of craftsmanship. Secret compartment. What kind of stone is this? I've never seen any substance quite like it. This appears to be the shrine of a Polynesian chieftain. Wow, really old photo. The island is wearing a lot of tribal ornaments, but none of them seem Polynesian. Not really sure how this thingamajig works. Oh, something's missing here. fascinating technology. Oh, oh my! Oh my goodness, what happened here? Black ooze again. Skin alterations. Like the ones on my hands. He's losing his mind. Cripes! This man was splashed with that black liquid.
Whoever took this picture must have a really cool head.
Those spots look all too familiar. Is this a picture of my hand? Erythrocytes. Aren't those red blood cells? I can't stand the smell of medical equipment. Reminds me of my illness. I'd better not touch it. And given what happened, they shouldn't have either. Is this stone structure a hatch of some sort? Well then, I'm going down. Come on, Nora. Deep breath. I can press these star-shaped tiles. Is somebody whispering? Hello? Is anyone down here? You were close to something here, Harry. Let me see if I can solve it. This looks like another job by Handyman Harry. Maybe he heard the whispers too. Depicts a ritual of some sort. What are they doing to their eyes? How old is this mural? It looks really ancient. Well, that was easy. This should save some time.
Are these ornamental? Or something else? Were these eyes related to the ritual? This eye... is it calling to me? I almost feel as if they're watching me. Do they have two pupils? I feel disoriented down here. Another eye. I hear whispering. I hear it. I'd better draw it just in case. The whispering, it stopped. Was I imagining all that?
Yes, I think I solved it. I wonder what I might be able to see with this lens. It fits. What? What on earth? What is happening? My God. What? What was that that I saw? What were those stars? Right, looks like I solved it.
Great Scott! Oh, the well is filling up. That's black ooze.
No.
It's happening. I'm feeling faint.
What is this? Where am I? Am I dreaming again? This is different. It isn't my recurring dream. I can't stop walking. My legs aren't responding. Holy Moses, what is that creature on the horizon? Wait a moment, No! I can breathe. Underwater. I have to get back. I have to find... What is that? What kind of creature is this? I need to get a closer look. This beach. Oh, I have a terrible headache. So far up the beach. What on earth could have happened to it? I'm terrified. I've always been afraid of storms, but something, or someone, seems to be moving there on the reefs. Or is it just my imagination? Looks like they took items from a stranded ship. The menu is rather limited here. It's too dark to see anything inside the tents. I should... Hey, this sailor is a dead ringer for my grandpa Isaiah. ship's hull was ripped open. A few jagged rocks couldn't have caused a gash of this size. This place gives me the creeps. I can't see any trace of the ship's crew, nor their remains. Dead as a doornail. No power. I'll try again. Nope, wrong. All green. Now, what exactly did I turn on? Voice. Is that Harry? No, just a recording. The ship was whaling not far from here. Even the crew of the ship that brought Harry's expedition to this island were afraid of it.
74 nautical miles east of Tahiti. The Lady Shannon has run aground. Its crew is...
This is the captain's last entry.
Five of us have survived, but we're stranded on this island. Please send help immediately. This is a distress call from the Everhart expedition. 74 nautical miles east of Tahiti.
Frank is certainly a resourceful man.
Unaccounted for. Five of us have survived.
What were you looking for in the heart of the island?
Maybe the legend is more real than it seems. These knobs must control the vibrations inside this chamber.
I'd better write down those numbers in my journal. The Black Ooze's properties are perplexing. And I was completely covered in that black goo. I wonder what it'll do to me. Only God knows how long I've been covered in this black liquid. I wonder what it's going to do to me. Although I doubt anything could be worse than my illness. Menu is rather limited here. Discarded clothing. It hasn't been worn in a long time. A handkerchief with the letters EDW embroidered on it. It's a white fedora. It's really dirty. Oh dear, this dock was a certifiable loon. These medical tools are hair-raising. I'm glad you stayed by his side, whoever you are. If Harry ever read this letter. These two fellows seem to get along pretty well. I don't know if someone in the expedition was a cook, but I really hope they didn't rely on Harry for it. When he lived in the dormitory, he only ate out of tomato soup and corn cans. I've never seen anybody with such poor nourishment. The expedition only has 5 members now.
Quick!
believe Harry visited this exposition when he was looking for answers for my illness. Photographic film. A portable typewriter. A pulp magazine. I love Chandra Hogarth's stories. Never heard of this Eric Zan fella. Someone took notes about some important dates. Did he take some amulets from the other campsite? Or did he call some more? I hope you didn't borrow this slide projector from the University of Denver, old pal. Rock stained with black ooze. Looks like the prototype of something. You always did have a good ear, Harry. How can someone build something like this out of stone? Look at the size of these stones. What kind of doodad is this? It's well tuned. I expected no less from you, old pal. These symbols are linked to the piano keys. rock stained with black ooze. Looks like the prototype of something. Sometimes I still doubt whether this isn't just some ghastly dream. It's curious, but it's the first time since I got sick that I feel useful. Harry is depending on me, and not the other way around. What odd structure. It doesn't look like a building, though. Captain Hodgson told me that knowing the lunar cycles is useful for better navigation at night. So, Harry probably took this calendar from the Lady Shannon. Thank you.
rock stained with black ooze. Looks like the prototype of something. Kind of improvised workshop. This must be the highest part of the island. And that diamond shape again. How striking. You made it work, Harry. Now it's my turn. So this is the reason the ship was scavenged. What kind of machine were you building? Blowtorch. Looks like it's been used a lot. Harry isn't usually very chummy, but he really seems to like Frank.
I've been interested in knowing how things work since I was a child, but I always thought technology wasn't for me. What nonsense. Huge stone door looks like an exit. How does it open? This ornate structure certainly isn't natural, but not man-made either. This feels ominous. Must be instructions to operate this bizarre structure. Those symbols seem to indicate the height of the tide. Quite scared of storms. When I was a child, I used to cover myself with the sheets to not listen to the noise of thunder. I honestly doubt I'd like to cover myself with anything in here. Time to overcome my fears, I guess. I've never seen Harry so angry. A rock stained with black ooze. Looks like the prototype of something.
My dear old pal, I think I'm getting closer to understanding what is happening to you, but it is taking a toll on my sanity. As fascinating as this island and its ancient and unfathomable wonders may seem, it's also a place plagued with misfortune and calamities.
We lost Roy at the campsite. We almost lost our engineer on this beach. The doctor went mad and stabbed him with a strange weapon. And all because of this island, Nora. Initially, we were optimistic and in high spirits, but now we've all become resentful and discouraged. Even I can feel how I am constantly assaulted by dark thoughts. Anyway, if what I am going through here helps me find you a cure, it'll have been worth it. I hope to find an answer in the temple on that mountain peak. Love you always, Harry.
My poor Harry. He is worried, exhausted, disheartened. I will find you, my love. Let's see what the next one does. Whew, that was quite a hike. I've been seeing these horseshoe-shaped pillars all the way up. Do they mark a path? I'm at the top of the mountain. I can see that giant diamond-shaped thing really close from here. Ah, took me a while to get here, but the views are worth it. This? Just with pieces from the beached ship. Frank sure must be a real whiz. His low spirits are obvious in this photo. What was wrong with Frank? He looked so thin. They built loudspeakers on top of this tower to reproduce the effect of the organ. Very clever, old pal. Nakal? So, this is like Atlantis, but in the Pacific Ocean, right? Harry is convinced the answer to my illness lies inside that temple. There are some sort of homemade loudspeakers, probably to amplify the sound. There's a symbol inside. This door looks thicker than any I've ever seen.
Another death?
Listen to me. Frank lost his life setting this whole thing up. So we're not going to discuss it anymore. We're going to activate it, period. Is that clear enough for you?
Caillou. Hey, Ma!
Fine, same to you. Please, Cass, activate. Working. Come on. Yes, it's working.
something wrong, Harry.
The ground is shaking. No.
No, I can't.
I told you we're off. You damn fool. You're going to kill us all.
Turn it off.
So I guess you used the notes from the organ and they weren't the right ones. Are these figures singing like a choir? These drops of rain are so refreshing. Feels really good. No! Frank died. Oh, Frank had a daughter named Evangeline. What a darling. They built a turbine to generate electricity under the falling water, but the stream isn't close enough to the wheel. These levers connect those gears to direct the wheel's energy into the turbine. He thought it was a flesh wound, but it kept getting worse. A Bible. It must have belonged to Frank. Blood-soaked rags. Sorry about Frank. Harry doesn't have many friends. When you finally do get to know him, he's so witty, so funny. A loving person. But it takes a lot for him to open up.
Are these figures singing like a choir? Heavens, looks like a rock slide crushed all the tents. All but one. They didn't accept Frank in the university. They should be ashamed. These stone columns just vibrate. Amazing! The hatches are opening.
Now the wheel is moving. No power. That was easy. These buttons seem to adjust the amount of energy that goes through the turbine. That should give the turbine some energy. Right, I did it. Now everything should be powered. Now that it's filled with water, it looks like a baptismal pool.
All right. Can you turn it on, Cass?
Please, sir.
No power.
What else do we need? Another death?
Listen to me. Frank lost his life setting this whole thing.
Oh, what? Did I do something wrong? Come on, work!
Come on. Now what? What's happening this time? Where am I? I can feel the fever rising. Oh God, no. My illness. Is it coming back? Is this an ocean? An ocean that dried up? These really are ancient bones of a very ancient creature. They are so dry. I need to find water. Oh. My bed. Another. How many times did I think I was going to die lying in this bed? I'd better find some shade before I dry right up. The horseshoe-shaped pillar and that diamond shape again. I can't take much more of this. I feel woozy. Is that a house? That's not a house. That's our house in Inglewood. Am I dreaming? Or am I just losing my mind? Harry? Are you home? I miss you so much, old pal. A picnic with Harry's brother and sisters. I started wearing gloves shortly after that day. Definitely losing my mind. I don't understand what is happening, Harry. Are you... Harry gave me this necklace after one of his scavenger hunts. It's a photo of my mother and me. She had just gotten worse from her illness. The happiest day of my life. And one of the... Happiest day of my life. And one of the few pictures of Harry without his glasses. My mother's music box. Yet again. Cousin Robert? But I don't have any cousins. What a sweet melody. The Everhart twosome. What a duo. What was that? Another vivid dream? And my music box again, but
It wasn't broken anymore. Homemade loudspeakers. Probably to amplify the sound.
All right. Can you turn it on, Cass?
Please, sir. We should not do this.
Not now.
Haven't we had enough warning, Mr. Everhart? What else do we need? Another death?
Listen to me. Frank lost his life setting this whole thing up. So we're not going to discuss it anymore. We're going to activate it, period. Is that clear enough for you?
Hey, you. Hey, Mom!
Fine, same to you. Please, Cass, activate.
Sung since I got sick, but let's give it a shot. Show. This feels like hallowed ground. Are they bathing him? In black ooze. His hands are changing, like in my dream. Look at those spots. They look like mine. Now he's some sort of man-fish? Fish of every size and shape. A giant fish head made of stone. This looks like the same kind of elevator that was in the campsite. These patterns look too familiar. She sounds worried for him, I think. Where is this taking me? Looks like I'm inside the giant fish head that I saw from below. I've seen this symbol in the mural several times. I guess it can be applied to both water and black ooze. It's amazing how words and symbols can keep their meaning after thousands of years. This one was easy, I think.
My dear old pal, Nora. I wish I could write something else, but a long time ago, I promised you I would never lie to you. So here goes. There is no cure for your illness. What you carry in your blood is changing you, and it will keep changing you until it's done. Whatever that means, there is nothing we can do to stop it. My dear old pal, my partner, the love of my life, I am so sorry. I've made so many mistakes. All those deaths because of me. Frank, DeWitt, Roy. All for nothing. Maybe Teaharo is right. Maybe we can return to the beach and build a raft to get back to Papiete. Maybe in less than a month, I could be back.
There's no cure? But he didn't finish the letter. What did you do, Harry? Where are you? I know for sure that you didn't go back home, so what? What do I do now? Are you still on the island? I have to find you. God's blood. Does this mean that... Is this related to me somehow, to my disease? So that's how you mark the symbol's orientation. I'm starting to understand this language. This one was really hard to figure out. Good job, Harry. Well done, Harry.
Boy, am I lucky that you did the hard part of figuring things out. John McCormack's dear old pal of mine? Our favorite song. Harry marked this symbol for a reason. I'd better write it down. A complex pattern.
Someone punched the wall so hard that they bled. Was it you, Harry? So that's how you mark the symbol's orientation. So that's how you mark the symbol's orientation. Harry threw a bottle against the wall. Was it because he was frustrated for not deciphering this? Or because of what he discovered when he did? A broken liquor bottle. Is this Harry's? He hates booze.